Good evening, friends. My name is JK Tejasvi, and as we discussed in the previous video, some multiple choice questions about the first unit of certified accounting and audit professionals. So there is a continuation of some bits, so let's get started. So what is the primary objective of auditing? So there are some kind of objectives that should be considered while doing auditing. First one is trueness of balance sheet. Second one, accounts are in accordance with the accounting policies. And third one, financial statements comply with the accounting standards. So these all the three are very much important and are the primary objectives of auditing. So answer is all the above. So second question, what are the incidental objectives of auditing? So there are two types of incidental objectives. First one is detection and prevention of errors, and detection and prevention of frauds. These two are the incidental oriented objectives of auditing. So the answer is both. Dash refers to the unintentional mistake in the financial information arising on account of ignorance of accounting principles. So there are some kind of mistakes that we do in the financial information. These generally we refer it as errors. Generally they call as errors. Dash are errors which arise on account of the transaction being recorded in the books of account either wholly or partially. So this kind of errors which we do on accounts of transactions, it is called it as error of omission. So error of omissions are the kind of errors which arise on account of transaction being recorded in the books of account either wholly or partially. So dash is the kind of error that made in the books of accounts either wholly or partially by making incorrect entries. So when we do some incorrected entries in the books of accounts, we get some kind of errors. This kind of errors we call it as error of commission. So incorrect entries are related to error of commission. So dash is the kind of error that occurs when two or more mistakes committed which counterbalance each other. So if one mistake is done, we do some sort of adjustment to close that mistake. So counterbalance will be doing. We call it as compensating error. Dash is the kind of error that occurs by not following the accounting principles. So if we do not follow the accounting principles, we face some kind of errors. We call it as error of principle. Error of principle is nothing but deviating the accounting principles. Dash is the kind of error that occurs due to the ignorance, carelessness and negligence. So if we are negligent in that kind of things, if we are carelessness and ignorance, these all three constitutes the clerical errors. Dash is an error committed intentionally to deceive or to mislead or to conceal with the truth or material facts. So these are the kind of mistakes which we do intentionally that leads to fraud. Frauds are generally classified into three types, namely misappropriation of cash, misappropriation of goods and manipulation of accounts. These are three kinds of fraud which are classified under frauds. Answer is all the above. So cash received from one customer is misused and cash paid from the second customer is adjusted to the first customer, and it goes on like that. Its process is called taming and lading. That means when the customer deposits the cash, and if the cash is misused by the cashier, so that cash should be recovered or should be placed in the exact amount what is paid by the customer number one. So the person who pays from the second customer, the amount is adjusted in the first customer, and from the amount will be reduced in the second customer account. So that amount should be compensated with the third customer deposit. So it's going on process because the first customer amount is misused by the cashier. So this process is known as taming and lading. So dash is the finalizing the accounts with intention of misleading others. So generally we observe during the quarter end or year end process of the preparing the balance sheets, it's nothing but window dressing. Window dressing means it was not actually there, but making it to appear. Window dressing. So in case of statutory auditor, he has to report to the central government. So in what is the limitation of amount where the statutory auditor has to report to the central government? If he founds in the case where the amount is more than 1 crore, the statutory auditor has to report it to the central government. In what case the amount the statutory auditor should report to the audit committee? So in the same way, in the previous one, here in which case he has to report to the audit committee. If the amount is less than 1 crore, he has to report that to the audit committee. So generally accepted standards are classified into three categories: generally standards, fieldwork standards, and reporting standards. The three are the generally accepted standards: general standards, fieldwork standards, and reporting standards. So dash is the recording of all the day-to-day transactions in the books of accounts leading to the preparation of financial statements. So here keyword is day-to-day transactions. Day-to-day transactions will be recording in the books of accounts. It's nothing but accounting. So dash is the critical examination of transaction recorded in the books of account. So the critical examination of transaction recorded in the books of account, that is auditing. So critical examination, nothing but auditing. Dash is the process to know the facts under enquiry. So here the word enquiry, we need to know the facts by doing some enquiry. It's nothing but investigation. And this is the end of unit number 1, introduction to the auditing and types of audit. So these are the questions which I found by reading the unit number 1. So I request you to follow the book once again, and I'll continue with the unit number 2 in my next video. Thank you.